Okay, time to face reality. We all push for the perfect family gathering, but as much as we love our loved ones, sometimes some of the things they say or do can just drive us plain crazy.
Yes, that's putting it lightly. Instead of feeling trapped, though, KCRA 3's Donna Cordova offers tips to surviving the gathering.
I'm doing two whole birds versus your one bird. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we'll see which one's better.
Bickering.
I guarantee that these are going to be better.
Or back and forth.
We might actually have conflict tomorrow.
To you, that's normal, but to throw an outsider into the mix.
Usually my wife's family, the sisters, they get a little bit loud, and that's when the guys go outside.
Carl Amara may be in the doghouse with that one, but with any luck, he'll be out in time to set up the mountain of chairs for his family gathering, which is going to be big and loud.
It's just intimate family, about 40 to 50 people coming in here tomorrow.
Experts say that's a good coping skill, realizing that your get-together isn't likely to be like the ones on TV.
And you just need to be aware of that and not expect everybody to be perfect over the holidays.
Okay, we need to get this guy out. Let's get this over there. And then what else do I need?
This couple says part of the prep work includes sleep, because some of the people they're expecting will bring their appetites and their opinions to the table, which they see as part of the fun.
No, nobody's going to be like brawling or fighting. No, not as cops aren't going to have to be called. Oh, I
got it, right? Dr. Margolis says our friends and relatives are who they are, and to expect otherwise is just setting yourself up to fail.
If you're realistic, you realize that Aunt Martha always gets drunk on Christmas.
The same goes for our kids. Don't expect absolute perfection, and you're likely to be a bit more thankful for what you have. In Yolo County, Donna Cordova, KCRA 319. So Dr. Margolis there warns about excessive drinking because, well, that tends to cause people to maybe lose their inhibitions and their judgment. Things get a little crazy. He also suggests maybe renting a hotel room as a place to escape just in case anyone needs a timeout.